Godavari, the largest river of peninsular India. The river is a lifeline for crores of people in India's newest state, Telangana. However, much of the river's torrential flow goes untapped, putting the brakes on the economic and human potential in the state. That is, until now. In 2008, the Telangana government laid out the vision for a massive engineering undertaking, the Kaleshwaram Lift Irrigation Scheme, or KLIS. It is one of the largest, most imaginative irrigation projects in independent India, and it's nearing completion in the district of Jaishankar Bhupalapalli. Its ambition and scope are breathtaking. Through a complex system of barrages, pump houses, tunnels and canals, waters of the Godavari would be lifted from the reservoir downstream to fertile areas upstream. The farmers in Telangana face a unique irrigation challenge.
Because the land is at very much higher elevation and the water is at very much lower elevation. So, lift irrigation is very much essential to feed the water to the entire state.
This makes it difficult to bring the water to farms for irrigation. KLIS was designed to address this problem. The impact of this project promises to be huge. The Godavari's main tributary, Pranahita, which literally translates into the life giver, is a torrent for 3 to 4 months. The plan is to use barrages to hold the water and move it upriver via gravity canals to irrigate over 18.25 lakh acres in 13 districts and stabilizing another 18.75 lakh acres in 7 more districts. To put this into perspective, KLIS will provide water for drinking, agriculture and industry in 20 of Telangana's 33 districts.
Kaleshwaram project is a very important project as far as Telangana government is concerned and also the Telangana state is concerned, wherein a lot of ambition is there among the people of Telangana.
KLIS posed an enormous engineering challenge. Three barrages at Medigada, Annaram and Sundala are the key parts of the irrigation system. The barrages not only store water, but also pump massive quantities of the precious resource upstream. Of the three barrages, Annaram is not the largest, but it is the most critical. The reason for this is that even as the larger barrage at Medigada is under construction, Annaram can still receive and store water for the lean months. The task of constructing the Annaram barrage was handed to Afcons in 2016. While the geological and logistical challenges were tremendous to begin with, the company was given a deadline of just 24 months.
When we saw Afcons, I've seen a different motivation and also the interest in the beginning of the work. So actually they started in a difficult conditions, as the farmers were not so much ready. Though they are ready actually giving their lands, the company has made a very good relation with them and they made convinced those people with the help of the government of Telangana, and in turn, IANCAD is supported them. And they have the zeal and interest and also the dedication for completion of this project in a report time of 1.5 years. So 18 months is a very, very small period. And they achieved it today, almost 99%, 96 to 97% work is completed by them. Normally, this magnitude of project will take not less than 5 years.
At the outset, a change in plan threatened to derail the schedule. The The location of the barrage was shifted, which increased the length to 1,270 meters. The change also meant that geological survey would need to be done at the new site once again. The result was extra work of more than 4,000 piles and 20% increase over the estimated quantities of concreting and steel. But there was no shift in the deadline. Undeterred, Afcons decided to invest more resources to make up for the lost time.
At every point of time, the government, exclusively at higher levels, including Chief Minister and Minister Irrigation, they cleared all the hurdles and made it a success.
The new geological survey threw up another challenge. The ground at the new site had differentiated strata.
The geological investigation, it is found that we are encountering different strata under the ground. It was sand, then even steep soil, and gravels and hard rock. In this type of changes, a sheet pile is not possible to drive. So I've changed this into secant pile.
Client decided to use secant piling in the cut-off foundation for the first time in the world in the construction of barrage. This involved the precise deployment of piling rigs for completion of foundation works. The team worked day and night. Braving temperatures as high as 50 degrees Celsius in summers and the fury of the Godavari in flood during the monsoon. The result, 1,500 ton of cement consumed per day, 200 metric ton of steel used per day, 5,500 to 6,000 cubic meters of concrete poured per day, a feat never achieved before by Afcons. More than 1 lakh cubic meters of concreting per month for 4 consecutive months. Afcons moved 80 lakh cubic meters of earthwork. All this was achieved with a clean safety record of 8.2 million safe man hours. The Annaram Barrage is testament to what can be achieved when Afcons set sights to the sky. The total capacity of Annaram Barrage is 10.87 TMC. It is 1,270 meters long with 66 radial gates, each 15 meters tall. There are 72 piers, each 100 meters long, 4 meters wide and 24 meters high. A road bridge with a carriageway of 7.5 meters runs on top of the piers and connects the two ends of the riverbank. It's a display of Afcons' engineering prowess, our spirit of innovation, and zeal to nurture and supply a precious natural resource to those who need it the most. Afcons. Building infrastructure, unlocking value, transforming lives.